Hello friend, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 Metric. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_045_BIABM where you see it. You can also download this file on the website or follow along with your own files. If you don't find any file, just sit down and watch the video. Now go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon, or hold down the Ctrl Shift S key on your keyboard. This brings the save drawing as dialog box. Rename this drawing to 00_046_BIABM. If you plan to open this drawing in an earlier version of AutoCAD in the future, change the file of type from AutoCAD 2018 to that version. Click this down arrow. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007. Click the save button. Zoom out to see the entire model. Now we need to link the roof in the first floor plan and the ground floor plan. To do that, we need to extend this surface from this point to this point. But in this approach, we are going to use a different technique. Make sure that you are in the drafting and annotation metric custom workspace. If you are not in this workspace, click this down arrow and select my drafting and annotation metric workspace. Select this surface, right click into drawing area, isolate object. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click this down arrow and select the way command. As specifying first point, click at the end point of this surface. As specifying through point, use the midpoint object snap or the perpendicular object snap and snap to this edge. Press escape. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this solid, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the polyline command. At specifying starting point, zoom in into this area and start from this vertex. Turn on the oval mode if it's off. Snap on this vertex. Press escape to get out of the command. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the polyline command. At specifying starting point, click at the midpoint of this edge, move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the isolate command. At the select object prompt, select this ray and press enter. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter and trim off this face. Press escape to get out of the trim command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press enter. Select this polyline and this polyline. Select this polyline and this polyline. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the on isolate command. Now select this surface, select this ray and this polyline, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At the select object prompt, select this ray, press enter. At the specifying base point, move the mouse cursor and use the midpoint object snap to this point, move the ray and snap into this end point. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. As specified first object point, click on this area, move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape. Select this line, make sure that your auto mode is turned on, click on this clip, move into this direction and type 33000, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. At the select object prompt, press enter. Select this ray to delete it. Press escape. Now select this line and hit delete on it. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object prompt, select this line, press enter. At the specifying extrusion endpoint, click at the endpoint of this line. Press enter to repeat the extrude command. Select this line, press enter. At specifying extrusion endpoint, move the line and snap to the endpoint of this surface. Go to the visual style control, click the down arrow and select 2D wireframe. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. go to the Home tab, Draw Panel, click this down arrow and select the 3D polyline. I specify first point prompt, start the, at this end point, move the mouse cursor and click on this end point, type C, and press enter to close the figure. Now let's bring the object that we delete, type oops on your keyboard, and press enter. Go to the visual side control, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this surface, go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and select the trim command. Select this surface and this surface, press enter, trim off this surface and this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Now hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. I specify first point prompt, click on this endpoint. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Move the mouse cursor into this direction, click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. At the select object prompt, select this line, press enter. At the specify height of extrusion, direction path, tap angle prompt. Go to the status bar and select the path option or type P on the keyboard and press enter. Select this line. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and click the trim surface command. At the select surface or region to trim point, click on the surface, press enter. At the select cutting curve or surface or region point, click on the surface, press enter. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button and zoom in close into this area and trim this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line and this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline command. I specify first point prompt, click on this endpoint, the endpoint of this surface, turn off the auto mode, click on this endpoint, this point, this point. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap to this, to the endpoint of this triangle. Snap to this endpoint, snap to this endpoint, this endpoint. Go to the status bar and turn on the auto mode. Move the mouse cursor into this endpoint and type 750 mm. Press enter. Now turn off the auto mode. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap to perpendicular of this line. Press enter to end the command. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this surface, hit delete. Select this line, hit delete. Go to the home tab, modify panel, select the trim command, press enter. Trim off this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and click the plan command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation to see the result. We need to trim off part of this surface. Now select this surface, this line, zoom in into this area, select this polyline, this surface, select this roof, select this surface, this line, this surface, zoom in into this area and select this polyline. Right click, select similar, right click, isolate, isolate object. Select this surface, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, select the trim surface command. At the select surface or region to trim prompt, select this surface, press enter. At the select cutting curve surface or region prompt, select this surface and this surface, press enter. Click to trim off this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. This surface is not nicely meeting this other surface, so we need to move this surface in this direction. Now if you look at this surface doesn't meet accordingly in the surface, and this surface needs to be joined to this other. Zooming into this area, we have two problems into this surface which we need to correct. We need to move this surface to meet this surface, and we move this edge of the surface to meet at the edge of this surface. First, let's treat this one first. Select this surface, right click, isolate object. Now go to the home tab, drop panel and select line command. I space my first point prompt, click at this endpoint, move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to start the line command again. Start the line from this point, and snap to this endpoint. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line, this surface, and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. At the select object from, select this line and this line. Type join on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and press enter. AutoCAD convert this into a polyline. Now type oops on your keyboard to bring the erase object. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Select this surface. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the plan command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Select this 3D polyline, zoom in into this area and select this polyline. Right click, select similar, right click, isolate object. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to get a better orientation. Now select this 3D polyline, hover the mouse cursor into this vertex and select the remove option. Click on this vertex and snap to turn on the perpendicular object snap and snap to this endpoint. Now hover the mouse cursor into this line and select the remove option. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Select this polyline, the 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the plan. AutoCAD convert this surface, this 3D polyline, into plan. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Now the surface fitting nicely in this area. We need to address another problem into this area. Select this surface. This surface, this slab, and this solid. Right click, isolate object. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Orbit, go to the home tab, drop panel, and select the 2D polyline command. Start the polyline at this vertex. Move the mouse cursor and snap to this endpoint. Snap to this vertex. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click press escape. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. As specify extrusion height prompt, click on this endpoint of the surface. Select this surface and this surface. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and click the trim surface command. At the select surface or region to trim point, select this surface and press enter. At the select cutting curve, surface or region point, select this surface, press enter. At the select area to trim point, hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button, click inside this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Select this 2D polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this surface and this slab, right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, drop panel, and select the polyline command. At specify first point prompt, snap at the end at the vertex of this solid. Move the mouse cursor and snap at the vertex of this solid. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to repeat the polyline command. Snap at the end point of this surface and move the mouse cursor into this direction and click. Now go to select this slab, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the Home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. At the select object point, select this line and this line. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this polyline and press enter. Move the mouse cursor down approximately 1000 millimeter. Press enter. Now go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, click the down and select the trim surface command. And select surface or region to trim from, select this surface. Press enter. As you select cutting curve, surface or region point, select this surface and press enter. Click to trim off this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this surface and the polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface, hold down the shift key on your middle mouse button to orbit and select this surface. Right click, isolate object. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the trim surface command. At the select object point, select this surface, press enter. At the select cutting curve, surface or region point, select this surface, hold down the shift key on your middle mouse button to orbit and select this surface, press enter. Click on this area to trim off this surface. Press escape to get out of the command. We need to get rid of this extra surface into this area. To do that, select this surface, right click, isolate object. We need to get rid of this small triangle. Now if I select this triangle is part of this surface. So the easiest way to do this, go to the home tab and make the cabbage layer the current layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel, click the down arrow and select the 3D polyline command. And specify face point, turn off the auto mode, snap from this endpoint, this point, type C on your keyboard and press enter. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the make current button. Select this surface. Select the surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this 3D polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and select the plan command. AutoCAD grid a plan from the 3D polyline. Select the surface and right click, isolate, hide object. Select the 3D polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface and this polyline. Right click, isolate object. Select this surface. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. As specified, face point, use the endpoint object snap, hover the mouse cursor. But as you can see, because of the mirror command is a 2D command, that's why you see the endpoint object snap at the X and Y plane, even when I hover the mouse cursor in the above the X and Y plane. Now click, move the mouse cursor, turn on the auto mode, and move into this direction. Click, press enter to end the command. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel, and click the trim surface command. At select surface or region to trim point, select this surface, press enter. At select cutting curve surface or region point, select this surface, press enter. Click to trim off the surface, press escape. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Now select this surface and this polyline. Right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Select this polyline. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. As specified, face point prompt, select the line from this point, move the mouse cursor and snap to this end point. Press escape. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and click the rotate command. At specifying base point prompt, click on this base point. Now turn on the auto mode if it's off and rotate the line into this direction. Select the line that you just draw. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At specifying base point prompt, click on this end point. Now move the mouse cursor and snap to this end point, but don't click. Type 750 millimeter. Press enter. AutoCAD move the line into place. Now right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Select this line, this polyline, and this surface. Right click, isolate object. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the add a specifying base point from. Select the base point of this line. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and snap to the endpoint of this line. Now select the line. Go to the 3D tool tab. Modeling panel and select the extrude command. And specify extrusion endpoint. Hold the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Snap to the endpoint of this surface. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tool tab. Modeling panel and select the extrude command. And specify extrusion endpoint. Move the mouse cursor and snap to the endpoint of this line. Go to the 3D tool tab. Surface panel and select the trim surface command. Add a select surface to trim from. Select this surface. Press enter. Add a select cutting curve surface origin from. Select this surface. Press enter. Add a select an area to trim from. Click outside the surface. Press escape to get out of the panel. Go to the 3D tool tab surface panel. Select the trim surface command. Add a select surface origin to trim from. Select this surface, press enter. As the select cutting curve surface origin point, select this surface, press enter. Click this surface, press escape to get out of the command. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. You need to trim this surface and this surface. Right click the UCS and select the face option. At the select face of a solid surface or mesh point, hover the mouse cursor into this surface and click. Press enter to accept. Now go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. As specifying first point point, click on this corner and move the mouse cursor and snap to the. Now select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. As specifying first corner point point, click on the corner of this surface. As specifying other corner point point, move and snap to this corner. Now we need to bring the object that we delete. Type oops on your keyboard and press enter. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the make current button. Click on this surface to make the layer of this surface the current layer. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel and select the plan command. It will create a plan inside the polyline that you select. Now, right click the UCS and select the world option. Select the polyline and hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel and click the trim surface command. Add the select surface origin to trim from, select this surface, press enter. Add the select cutting curve surface origin point. Go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel and select the trim surface command. Add the select surface origin to trim from, select this surface and this surface, press enter. Select this surface and this surface, press enter again, click this area and click on this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now this surface extends to the other area. It works as if the associated view was on when you go to this surface. Let's try and extrude this polyline again. Select the polyline and click the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into the positive Z axis and click. Go to the 3D tool tab surface panel and select the trim surface command. Select this surface, press enter. Select this surface, press enter. Click to trim off this area. Press escape. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. Hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. We need to get rid of some of this excess surface. To do this, select this surface, and this solid. Right click, isolate objects. Go to the home tab, layer panel, click the down arrow and select the cabbage layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. At specifying first point prompt, click at the end point of this line. Move the mouse cursor. Turn on the auto mode by clicking the auto mode button or press the F8 key. Move the mouse cursor and use the perpendicular object line and snap to the edge of this surface. Press escape. Now go to the 3D tool tab, surface panel and select the trim surface command. At the select surface or region to trim from, select this surface, press enter. at the select cutting curve, surface or region point, select this line, press enter. At the select an area to trim point, click on this area, press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click into the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. We still have some problem to address in this area, but that's okay, we're going to address this problem in a minute. Now select this surface and this polyline. Right click, isolate object. Go to the home tab, drop panel and select the line command. And specify first point prompt, start at the end point of this line, move the mouse cursor and snap to the end point of this line. Press escape. Press enter to repeat the line command. Start from the end point of this line, hold down the shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit and snap into the end point of this line. Press escape. Zoom in into this area, select this surface, right click, isolate, hide objects. Right click the UCS, select the face option. At the select face of solid, surface or mesh point, click on this face, press enter to accept. Now go to the home tab, drop panel and select the 2D polyline command. As specified, starting point prompt, start from this point, and this point, the intersection of this point. Type 3 on your keyboard and press enter to close the figure. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the make current button. Select this surface. Select this surface and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this polyline. Go to the 3D tools tab, surface panel and select the plan command. AutoCAD convert the polyline into surface. Right click the UCS and select the world. Right click the drawing area. Isolate end object isolation. Now go to the home tab, layer panel and select the isolate command. Select any object on the cabbage layer and press enter to isolate the cabbage layer. Select this roof, right click and select isolate hide object. Now use a window selection to select all these lines and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click in the drawing area, isolate end object isolation. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the on isolate command. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. As the select source object point, select this surface and select this surface. Press escape on your keyboard to get out of the command. Now it's a time to bring all of our roof together. This roof will get them on a different layers. So to do that, go to the home tab, layer panel and click the down arrow, select the match command. Go to the view cube and click the front face of the view cube. At the select object on layer to match prompt, select this surface. Press enter. At the select objects on target layer or name prompt, because we don't have any objects on the target layer, so if we are having an object in the target layer, the simplest way is just to click that object. To that, move all this object on that layer and purge this layer. But now that we don't have that object in drawing, select the name option on the status bar or type N on your keyboard and press enter. This will bring the merge layer dialog box with all the layer in the drawing listed here. Scroll down and look for the roof layer. Select the roof layer and click the OK button. AutoCAD warns you, you are about to merge 6 layer into layer roof. Do you want to continue? Select the yes option. As you can see, all the objects on this layer are moved to the roof layer. Now if you click the down arrow, the R1 to R8 are gone except for the R3 and R7. Now hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Now select this surface, right click, select similar, right click, isolate object. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. As the select source object prompt, select this surface. As the select destination object prompt, use a window selection to select all of these objects. Press escape to get out of the command. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button to orbit. Right click, isolate, end object isolation. There you are. Now you see the complete roof of our model. Go to the navigation bar for the moment and click the orbit command to see the results. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the view control, click the custom view and select the SW isometric. Click the view control, select SA isometric. Click the view control, select NA isometric. Click the view control and select NW isometric. Click the view control again, select the SA isometric. It's like you need one more roof to move. So go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object form, select this surface. At the select destination object form, select this surface. This surface. Hold down the shift key and the middle mouse button. Select this surface. This surface. This surface. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the custom view and click the SE isometric. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. Control key and type S to save this window. Now type purge on your keyboard and press enter. At the purge dialog box, click the purge all command. In the purge confirm dialog box, select the purge all item and click OK to close. AutoCAD purge all the layer except the layer and on the layer that have objects in there. If you click down the down arrow, the cabbage layer is even gone. The reason that you see the R3 layer, because the R3 layer was the current layer when we used the purge command. Now, go to the Home tab layer panel and select the make current button. At the select object on which layer will become current, select this wall. Go to the Home tab layer panel and click the layer properties. This brings the layer properties manager. Select the R3 and hit delete on your key and click the delete layer button. Close the layer properties manager. Hold down the control key on your keyboard and type S to save this model. Now go to the Home tab, layer panel, click the down arrow and select the cabbage layer to make it the current layer. Type purge on your keyboard and press enter. This brings the purge object dialog box. Select the purge all button. This brings the confirm purge dialog box. Select the all item and close the dialog box. Also that purge all the layers that don't have objects in them and the other items that are not in use in the drawing. Press escape to get out of the command. This is the end of this video. As you can see, whatever complex your roof may be, you can model that roof if you divide it into partial roof. The easiest way to do this, create layer for each partial roof. During the construction, you can switch on and off, thaw and freeze a particular layer. When you complete, you move all of the objects to the roof layer and purge that temporal layer. So this is the end of this video. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.